Hello everyone and welcome to episode 14 of Markoid Builds, and I want to start with wishing you all a happy new year. This year we'll continue on making the a lot of wonderful builds, and straight away start over that. As you maybe can see behind me, I finished up some of the area around the Magus Tower. It's all smaller builds, so I didn't want to bother you with just doing small houses and some farms and stuff like that. We'll have a quick fly around, but after that we're gonna start on building a fishing harbor in the bay. You have seen that before already in one of the episodes, and with that construction will actually tie the Magus Tower area together with the other already constructed area around the arena. Let's do a quick fly around, see what I have constructed so far on around the Magus Tower. And then we can continue on the area. It has become a bay now, where we're gonna make the fishing harbor. So let's do a fly around. So, and here's the area as it looks now. So you can see I made some more custom trees. Over on this area, I made some farms. Build a barn there. Got some animal pens. And you see I made a wall. So now also that island is connected. Over here, also I added some more ruins. And also here I added some more houses, some small, some a bit bigger, and some have a functionality, like for instance this one. It's a small honey farm. As you can see here, the bees can fly in and out. Over here I made a small blacksmith. It's actually based on an existing building as well, which is actually from a small village called Birre Kerke. Added a small house over here. I actually like this roof style, so maybe I'm gonna do something with it in another build. I don't know yet. For now, there you see the defensive wall. And it goes all the way down to the bottom. So yeah, that means that this area is now protected by these chains to prevent ships from entering the harbor. And I already started on this here. This will actually be the key site, a little bit same as over there. And I did a little bit different. Over here on this area I used slabs. And actually I like this look better. The only problem about using the slabs is that if you place chests or barrels on top, then obviously that won't work, because of course they will float. So that is over here. I used solid blocks, but I'm not sure about this placement of the anvils yet, because I want to use the anvils as bollards. And now, I don't know, but I think that anvils can stand on slabs as well. So what I might do is that I just place a slab here and put the anvil on top. So that's something to try out. What I want to do here, I want to make into the mountain side. I want to make the how do you call that? The warehouses, the storage rooms for the fishing vessels. Over here in the bay, I want to have the fleet of fishing vessels ready to go or moored up for the night. And over here in this area, I'm not sure if we're gonna get to that this episode. Over here, I want to make a dry dock for vessels. As I said, I'm not sure if we will come to that. But yeah, we're gonna give it a shot, and we'll see how far we're gonna get. So let's start building. Okay, so we got the first storage area complete, so the first set of warehouses, if you want to call it that. Got some fish tanks here with live fish, and then here the crates with all the fish that is ready to be shipped off. So it's time to put some fishing vessels into the harbor. Let's jump into that. Thank you. So, as you can see, I did some small modifications on the ship after I stopped the time lapse. Just added some more details, got some more color into the sails. Also, I added another type of fishing vessel, as you can see. So, what we're gonna do now is actually we're gonna add another warehouse, and it's gonna be similar as one that I used already in my village, next to the other huge ship, close to the cathedral. So, yeah, let's first make a quay site and then start building another warehouse. Have the warehouse finished inside and out. So let's have a look inside. Ooh. Oh yeah, that's right, I'm in spectator mode. So yeah, I did some floorings in it. So let's move up here. You see the rooms are interconnected by these doorways. So yeah, looks pretty decent if you ask me. Obviously, I'll have to fill them with all kinds of goods. But yeah, the harbor is getting like a proper harbor. So the next thing will be to do something in this corner. Not sure what, or maybe I will start on the dock. That may be an idea that I do that, and then I can see how everything fits in together. And I will also add some more vessels in the bay area here. So that will be the next task for now. So let's hop into that. So, as you can see, I have started planning out a dock, and actually what you see here, that is the size that I want to have on the bottom of the dock. I just counted out the length of the ship, and that is the complete length, so that is from the bowsprit all the way up until the rudder, and that is 28 blocks. So, and if you look over here, you think, well, this is a lot bigger than one of those fishing vessels. In fact, it is not. I think that I've taken two blocks spare, so the bowsprit will end somewhere over here, and the stern will be right over here. So, what I'm gonna do first is dig out a hole covering the area where the ship is gonna be, and then I will make walls that gradually come up. So that should be good. I may have to dig into this a little bit, but as you can see, we have plenty of space and the terrain already curves in the right way, so I think it will work out actually perfect. So okay, let's start digging. And with the dry dock complete and the two fishing vessels added, or the three, well, one in the dry dock and one ready to sail out of the bay, the other moored up alongside. This area is becoming more and more complete. I added another buoy down here, a navigational buoy. I think that there's only one area that I'm missing something here, and that is actually the area here next to the dry dock and the warehouse. I want to have something here, I wanted to look industrial. But I was not sure what I want to do there until yesterday. My daughter was sitting next to me with her laptop and her Minecraft build, and she showed me something, and I thought this will fit perfectly there. The only problem is the mountain cannot stay. So yeah, again, terraforming. So we'll have to chop away this mountain to add the build. But yeah, well, we've done that before. So let's chop away the mountain and start building the build. This we have come to the end of this episode. As you see, the bay is now filled with fishing vessels and fishing activity. We made a shipyard, a dry dock. Let's quickly fly over there to... Oh my god, clicking is hard. Oh my god. Let's fly over the bay. And over the dry dock. Into the workshop. So we got a lot of villagers working here, repairing the ships. Got a storage in here with some logs and just general storage with ship parts and stuff like that. So, and then here, out on the quayside, there's some supplies ready to be hoisted to the ship, which is in dry dock. And the villagers are working there as well to repair the ship. And the fisherman is, I think he's inspecting the work that is going on. Oh, it must be a lunch break. All of them are leaving the area. This is interesting. Well, maybe it's the end of the day. Okay, so with that, I say see you guys later. If you liked the video, leave a like. Don't forget to subscribe. And until next time.